Welcome to ryagurkul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about what is velocity chart and how to view and understand the complete logic of building a velocity chart. So if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. So what you'll get it from this video, we'll discuss here what is velocity chart, how to generate a velocity chart, and how to view it with the complete analysis. So without wasting time, let's jump to the Jira login credential where we are able to see all the project leads are available. For generating a velocity chart, we have to select any specific project or board and we'll generate it. So before proceeding further, let's understand what is velocity chart. Velocity chart shows the amount of value delivered in each sprint, enabling you to predict the amount of work the team can get done in future sprint. It is useful during our sprint planning meetings to help decide how much work we can easily commit to. So let's see how we can fetch the velocity charts. So I'm selecting the project name where we have to navigate to the reports. Inside that, when you will scroll down, you will find it out velocity chart here. Same thing is available in report section as well. You can generate it directly from here. So I'm selecting this velocity chart and see how it looks. Now you can see for this current sprint, the velocity chart is generated like this. So let's understand how it looks and how it's working. So if you can see in the name, this is a story points is listed here. So right now in my particular stream, there are 20 story points are generated. So this will show up the commitment. Whatever we have committed is this bar, and whatever we have completed is showing this bar. And in the down section, that is on the x-axis, we are able to see the sprints. So let's understand each and every term in detail. So estimation statistics is on the y-axis, displays the statistics used for estimation of user story in point wise. In this example, the team is using story point estimates can also be based on the business value, hours, issue count, or any numeric field of our choices. Commitment is nothing but this gray color bar of each sprint shows the total estimates of all the issue in the sprint when it begins. After the sprint has started, any stories added to the sprint or any changes made to estimates will not be included in this total. Completed is showing in the green bar, that is the bar which shows the sprint total completed estimates when the sprint ends. Any scope changes made after the sprint started are included in this total. And at the end, in the x-axis, we are able to see sprints having last 7 sprints. As of now, in this board, I am having just 1 sprint. Otherwise, if you have last 7 sprint, which is populated here, the complete detail analysis is present here. So let's understand how we can calculate the velocity. A team recent velocity can be useful in helping to predict how many or how much works can be completed by team in a future sprint. Velocity is calculated by taking the average of the total completed estimates over the last several sprints. So in this chart, let me calculate the total of the velocity is somewhere around 20. So the total completed story point is 20 here. So if we have multiple sprints, then we can calculate all this together or sum up all this together and divide by 6. So which will give us, or divide by the how many sprints we have. So divide by 6 will give us the average velocity of our team. This value should become more accurate and reliable over the time as more data becomes available and the team gets better at estimates issue. Estimates from subtasks are not included in the velocity chart calculations. So this is how we can calculate velocity chart and generate the velocity report in particular sprint or in particular project or board. That's all about velocity chart in Jira. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed the session, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.